Captain.
We're waiting, sir.
Waiting for what?
Private Doss.
Who the hell is Private Doss?
Hello, and welcome to Film Rant. Hopefully this is the last of my reviews that comes late due to the UK being a right twat for getting films late in January. Of all the Oscar bait films to come out this month, this one, along with La La Land, were the only two I thought were really worth seeing. It seemed to have a story that wasn't like anything I've ever really seen before, and it stars my boy Andrew Garfield. I still wake up in hot sweats during the night knowing he's not Spider-Man anymore, but I'll take anything I can get, even if the movie is directed by a homophobic, racist, wife beater. Congratulations, you're a dick. I'm feeding off scraps here, guys, all for my fix of Garfield. Anyway, can this prick make a good movie in Hacksaw Ridge? Well, I'm going to talk about spoilers in this review, but that shouldn't bother much of you anyway, seeing as it came out in America about 46 years ago, but I'll give you the warning. So let's get started with Garfield's character, Desmond Doss, our hero and indeed, a real life hero. I thought Garfield did a terrific job when it came to portraying the kind of guy Doss seems to be. I'm no dialect expert either, but I thought his accent was solid for a guy that talks like a Hogwarts reject. Garfield really drew me in and I loved getting to know Doss throughout the movie. He successfully shows a character who is very easy to empathise with. You feel sorry for him so much when he's trying to get through boot camp. His utter devotion to his cause is also very infectious. I felt inspired to see him succeed in his plan. I was really rooting for him to do what he wanted to do in the movie, and it's been a while since I got behind the main character as much as I got behind Doss. Whether he was actually like this in real life, I'll never know, but Garfield really did well portraying this infectious, kind and devoted soul. Hugo Weaving plays Desmond's dad, Tom Doss. Weaving was probably the second most interesting character in the movie. He was definitely the most realistic. A man traumatized by the horrors of war and seeing his friends killed in front of him, he's a haunted dude. As a result, he turns to the bottle and ends up doing a Mel Gibson and gives the missus a slap now and again. Now, I'm not saying that all war vets are like this, but ex-soldiers who suffer from PTSD can occasionally exhibit this sort of behaviour. Weaving is a very troubled character and is half of the reason why Desmond takes the stance he does when it comes to not killing. While I absolutely condone his actions, I mean, I have to say he's basically just Mel Gibson Matrix edition, Weaving is a very understandable character, in that I can't even begin to comprehend what's going on in his head, so I sure as hell can't judge him harshly for the man he is. I just thought Tom Doss was a very true and harsh character that really gave some great moments to Desmond's backstory. On the flip side, Vince Vaughn and Sam Worthington play the generic stone-faced army superiors, with the small exception that Vince Vaughn has some terrific banter. When he approached Ghoul and asked him, "How long have you been dead, Private?" That was a highlight. Vaughn is a tough sergeant, but he's very funny to watch, so he has that going for him. Sam Worthington, though, doesn't really have any redeeming qualities. He's flat and only really becomes truly relevant near the end, but I think the less said about him, the better. The only other two characters I want to talk about are Desmond's wife Dorothy, played by Teresa Palmer, and Smitty Riker, played by Luke Bracey. Dorothy doesn't seem to serve a large part of the story, she's mostly there just so we can attach Desmond to his home. She's the stakes. If Desmond dies, she's lost her husband, who she loves very much. She's a relatively minor character in the grand scheme of things, but her presence is welcomed. The same can be said for Smitty. He's sort of Desmond's bully in boot camp, and you just know that that'll all change once the shit hits the fan and he'll redeem himself. What I didn't expect was a scene in the trench where he shared his backstory, how his father could have been any one of 10 guys and his mother died when he was young, so he was moved from orphanage to orphanage. I like that the movie took the time to flesh him out a bit rather than just making him a dick for the hell of it. I ended up liking him in the end. With regards to the script, I loved how well set up Garfield's motivation was. Throughout the movie, he attributes his Batman rule to his religious beliefs, but I don't really believe that, at least not in the context of the film. I honestly just think he doesn't want to end up like his dad, since it was because of his violence that nearly led him to killing his brother when he clocked him with a brick. That guilt from nearly killing his brother, I feel, is a big catalyst for his future beliefs. Yeah, he looks at a mural when his brother is touch and go and happens upon the commandment of thou shalt not kill, but telling people you don't want to kill for religious reasons is much easier than telling them you nearly stoved your brother's head in because your dad's a violent wife and child beater, right? Don't get me wrong, I do think that religion does have something to do with it, but not as much as he makes out. I wasn't expecting to get such a fleshed out setup for his belief, so I was very happy with how the film built the structure of his character. Hacksaw Ridge is a thoroughly gripping story, for the most part. The first half of the movie where we see Doss meet his wife and see his struggles through boot camp was brilliant. I was absolutely gripped with the story and the first half of the movie totally flew by. Then we get Okinawa and we get our first battle scene, which was magnificent, but then the movie sort of slows right down, then goes all balls to the wall again, then slows down again, then goes all out again, and it just chops and changes for just over an hour. It just got a little bit repetitive after a while. The scenes themselves were all amazing, but I just feel like the whole second half of the movie ran just a little too long in the end, and I began to lose a bit of interest. That said, there was one element of the story that I really enjoyed throughout. As you can guess, this movie is split into two halves, the events before the battle and the battle itself. In the events before the battle, the big major focus is on Doss's belief that he can't or won't carry a weapon because he doesn't want to kill. Obviously, most if not all of his comrades and superiors think the dude's crazy, and the movie explores the struggle he has trying to convince the army to let him serve, and that he has the conviction and patriotism to still be able to do his bit even though he isn't killing the enemy. The movie intentionally makes it a big deal because, well, it would be. But in the second half of the movie during the battle, it's never really referenced directly, ever. I can't recall a single time where a character says, "How are you getting on without a gun?" or "Told you you should have had a weapon." Thankfully, there also wasn't a moment where Garfield is caught deer in the headlights style by a Japanese soldier and has to be rescued by a comrade, which would have then led you to think, yeah, maybe he should have had a gun there. Instead, the movie focuses on the sheer brutality of war, which I loved. I get the impression Gibson was basically saying it doesn't matter if you have a weapon or not. The difference between life or death on a battlefield is a split second. 1 minute you're alive holding your rifle, or not as the case may be, and the next you have a bullet through your eye and you're eating dust. The relatively minor issue of being a medic without a weapon pales in comparison to the terrifying horror of people being burned alive and seeing your friends being blown to pieces. And that takes me on to the violence in this movie. I've seen a lot of comparisons to Saving Private Ryan in other people's reviews, and I agree. While I think the set pieces in the movie as a whole are significantly worse than Saving Private Ryan, the violence of both movies are about the same. Gibson is known for being a violent son of a bitch both off-screen and on-screen with movies like Passion of the Christ and Braveheart, and he doesn't shy away in Hacksaw Ridge. We see soldiers with their legs blown off, intestines on the floor, people scorched and torn apart. It's brutal. I can always appreciate that in war movies. Some people understandably think it's overkill and they don't like seeing gore, I totally get that, but I think in war movies it's essential to show the horror of a battlefield, especially in this one. How does our hero cope without having a weapon to protect himself, and better yet, he's a medic? He has to treat his friends and comrades with these horrific wounds and they're relying on him to survive. Showing just how unforgiving the battlefield is really raised the stakes for our hero, and it gave us a relatively good idea of just how terrifying it must have been for the real Desmond Doss. There was one thing I would have changed though, and it's only minor. In the opening shots we see Garfield being stretchered off the battlefield and it briefly cuts to a first person perspective. I would have loved to have seen that whole sequence in first person. He gets carried off on a stretcher, we see his comrades above telling him he'll be okay and they're getting him to safety. As he looks around, we see people be shot, blown up, burned, cry, shout, shake, sort of like how you see war in Battlefield 1. I just think that would have been a truly harrowing way to open the movie, but I'm still perfectly happy with what we got. One of the only things that lowers the quality of this movie is its cliches and very filmy moments. Garfield eventually saving the life of his bully was quite cliche and you could see it coming from the moment he met him. There was a section where Garfield is rescuing Vince Vaughn by dragging him through the battlefield while being chased by a small troop of Japanese soldiers. Now throughout the movie the Japanese have been able to dome twats through thick smoke and from considerable distance. They were depicted to be quite accurate and quite skilled soldiers during the battle. The US looked a little overwhelmed. But then when Garfield and Vaughn are making their escape, in a straight line I might add, the Japanese would be the underdogs in a shooting range target match against stormtroopers. They all of a sudden just become inaccurate and you may as well see a shield pop up around Vaughn and Garfield that says plot armor on it. The romance scenes are also quite cliched, but they're also very weird. Garfield is very intense and forward and you have to think that if this guy didn't look like Andrew Garfield and instead looked like, well, me? Dorothy would make like Iron Maiden and run for the fucking hills. The romance scenes are very Edward and Bella-esque and they just felt so rushed and a little creepy. I can understand why they're rushed because the film had to move along with its core plot, but they were just weird. I also wasn't a fan of the stealth tunnel scene where Garfield decides to do his best impression of Solid Snake. It just felt forced, like the movie needed a bit of tension where it was just Doss by himself without his weapon. I just didn't think the scene was necessary. Whether it actually happened or not, I don't really think it's relevant to the story. I really enjoyed the final few minutes of the movie where we see some of the real-life counterparts of the movie's characters talking about the battle and Doss himself. It just really added this sense of authenticity and it was nice to put a face to the name other than the actors. Seeing Doss talk about the battle and seeing videos of him be commended for his heroics gave me this brilliant sense of joy and I sort of felt proud of him as if he was a friend or relative of mine. A nice touch was also how they included the story of Doss wiping away blood from a comrade's eyes, after which he smiles and proclaims he thought he was blind. It was great to see that in the movie itself and then to directly reference it in the documentary at the end. I know most biopic or documentary style films have this sort of ending, but it's still nice to see even if it is quite common. What's particularly interesting about this movie is that it's one of the few war movies I've seen that is almost completely focused on just one individual. Saving Private Ryan focuses on Tom Hanks more than anyone else, but ultimately the movie focuses on the troop as a whole. Black Hawk Down does the same. Hacksaw Ridge, while it devotes some screen time to Doss's fellow soldiers, the movie itself is really just about him and his story, not their story. I feel like it would be very difficult to make a war movie just about one person, as war is very much a team effort. Understatement of the century right there, but you get my point. Somehow though, Hacksaw pulls it off. Fuck's sake, man, I want to hate Mel Gibson because he seems like a despicable person, but damn, the dude could make a good flick. From a technical standpoint, I liked how the movie changed its look with regards to the two halves thing I mentioned earlier. When we see Desmond's childhood, his motivation for his beliefs and his love story, the movie looks very colourful and it's all very calm and collected. Then when the shit hits the fan in Okinawa, the movie suddenly becomes this desaturated, dirty, loud and violent attack on you. I'm a big fan of well-made visual cues, and I think the colour grading and sound design in both halves of the movie are very well crafted and divide the movie brilliantly. That said, the movie does have a lot of pacing issues, and I mean a lot. There's a scene early on where Desmond's brother enlists in the army and Hugo Weaving goes a bit mental because he knows his son is going to be subjected to the same terror as he was. Then, nothing comes of that. The next thing we know, Garfield is telling his missus he's enlisted in the army. We see no scene where it looks like he's even remotely considering joining. If we saw Garfield go and talk to the brother after he's told to get out of Hugo Weaving's sight, then we could have set it up. Garfield could just say, "I know Daddy ain't happy, but I know why you did it. I'm thinking about enlisting myself. I want to defend my country as much as the next guy," or something like that. Just one sentence would do. I've already mentioned how rushed the romance story is and the pacing really forces us through that, and it just feels like you're having your head pushed through a straw. In the second half of the movie, it really doesn't phase well between battle scenes and calm scenes. I'm not saying the battle has to come to an end for a calm scene to then come in, but we need to see a moment where it slows down. We could have had Garfield drag a guy to the edge of the ridge, which seems to be a safe zone, then take a breather. After that breather, we can cut to the nighttime scene where he's in the trench talking to Smitty. I feel like the editing in the second half could have just done with a little more work. It's a bit of a rollercoaster with slow, calm builds and then fast, loud action scenes. Finally, I think a few scenes ended a little too soon. I wanted to see more of the aftermath when Garfield told Vince Vaughn he wasn't going to bear arms. I wanted the trench scene with Smitty to go on just a little bit longer, and as I mentioned earlier, I wanted to see some sort of aftermath with the brother joining the army. The movie has a runtime of 2 hours 20 and it feels like there could have been a lot more added to it to flesh everything out and make it a bit smoother. Maybe we'll get a director's cut at some point, because it's clear that some of this movie was cut for time. Overall, Hacksaw Ridge is a visceral, exhilarating and engaging tale that I feel does justice to the Desmond Doss story, judging by what I've read. Andrew Garfield is absolutely fantastic and plays an infectious, extremely likeable character who was judged simply for being different. Hugo Weaving is a darkly realistic depiction of a vet struggling with PTSD. Vince Vaughn and Sam Worthington are a bit generic but essential to the story, and there's something surprisingly enjoyable about the stereotypical bully villain. The movie does suffer from some cliches and poor pacing, but they seem like minor issues in an otherwise gruesome, well-told and gripping tale. Hacksaw Ridge definitely deserves the majority of its Academy Award nominations, with the exception of editing. As I said, pacing issues galore. It's a movie worth seeing, and if you're American, it's probably now a fucking classic, but if we're in the UK, go and check it out when you can. Hacksaw Ridge gets 4 frames out of 5. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Film Rant.
Help me get one more.